إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهديه الله تعالى فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إقرارا بربوبيته وإرغاما لمن جحد وكفر كل من عليها فان ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام. يقول ربكم سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Allah the Exalted, He mentions in His glorious book, O you who believe, fear Allah the fear that He deserves, and do not die except in the state of Islam, which is submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear respected brothers in Islam, we begin by praising Allah azza wa jal, and we send our peace and blessings among our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. On a day-to-day occasion, every single one of us in this room leaves the house, be it in the day or the night, and he comes back in order to provide for his family, in order so he can go and work and save up. On a day-to-day basis, we leave the house and we go to work. And at times, we face hardships financially. At times, we hit brick walls and we think we can't make it. At times, we've hit rock bottom, and the only thing that you think you've got in your wallet is rocks. So you open your wallet and you haven't got any money inside. You've hit a car on the road, and you need to pay off the damage that you've caused, but you don't have the money for it. You have a newborn coming in 6 months. You don't feel like you're financially ready. You're moving out of your house in 2 months' time. You need to save up for a bond and 2 weeks of extra rent. You don't feel like you're financially ready. At times, we feel like we've hit the bottom and we don't have the provisions. We don't have the sustenance. At times, we think, I need the money. I need the money. My brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the Quran, He mentions, speaking of rizq, sustenance, provisions, Allah azza wa jalla, He says, قُلْ إِنَّ رَبِّي يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Say that it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who amplifies the wealth and the sustenance and the rizq, and He is the one who also decreases it. You have to understand something. When at times you think like you don't have enough money, Allah Azza wa Jal puts you in this situation for a very, very good reason. A hikmah that He knows that you don't. You see, Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who gives the rich person the money that he has. And Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who decreases the money in your pocket and in your bank account. For a hikmah that He knows. For a hikmah that He knows and you don't. Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who provides for you, and Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who decreases the amount of wealth that you have. It is Allah Azza wa Jal that provides. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I have not created mankind and jinkind except to worship me. ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون. I don't want from them wealth. I don't want from them to feed me. I don't want from them these materialistic things. إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. Verily and indeed, it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who sustains and He's the one who provides. My dear respected brothers in Islam, Allah Azza wa Jal created you to worship Him, not to run after the dollar. Allah Azza wa Jal created you to worship Him, not to run after your rizq day and night, thinking that you're going to get more than what Allah Azza wa Jal has written for you. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who provides. It is Allah Azza wa Jal who is the sustainer. You see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we've established that He's the sustainer, the provider, the one who gives. Yet Allah Azza wa Jal does something very beautiful in the Qur'an. In five different locations in the Qur'an, in five different occasions in the Qur'an, He describes Himself to be the best of providers. The best of providers. خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ. Allah Azza wa Jal, He mentions in the Qur'an, on the tongue of Isa alayhi salam, قَالَ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَ اللَّهُمَّ رَبَّنَا اللَّهُمَّ رَبَّنَا أَنزِلْ عَلَيْنَا مَائِدَةً مِنَ السَّمَاءِ تَكُونُ لَنَا عِيدًا لِأَوَّلِنَا وَآخِرِنَا وَآيَةً مِنْكَ وَارْزُقْنَا وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ وَارْزُقْنَا وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ. In another occasion in the Quran, Allah Azza wa Jal, He says, وَالَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ قُتِلُوا أَوْ مَاتُوا لَيَرْزُقَنَّهُمُ اللَّهُ رزقا حسنا والله خير الرازقين وإن الله لهو خير الرازقين. In another occasion, Allah Azza wa Jal, He mentions in the Quran, أم تسألهم خرجا فخراج ربك خير والله خير الرازقين والله خير الرازقين. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who is the best of providers. One of the pious predecessors was asked, why does Allah Azza wa Jal mention and He calls Himself the best of providers? You see, this man knew and he understood. He says, Allah Azza wa Jal, He says that He is the best of providers because He gives the kafir, the one who disbelieves in Him, the one who disbelieves in Allah Azza wa Jal, the one who transgresses and he disobeys Allah Azza wa Jal, He gives him from His bounty and He lets him swim in the bounty of Allah Azza wa Jal in the day, in the night, every single day on a recurring basis. He gives it to him even though he disbelieves in Allah Azza wa Jal. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentions and He calls Himself خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ, the best of providers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in another occasion in the Qur'an, He mentions,
قُلْ إِنَّ رَبِّي يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ وَيَقْدِرُ لَهُ وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُهُ وَهُوَ خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ.
In another occasion, in the last occasion, in the fifth occasion in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes Himself in the Quran, the best of providers, He says,
وَإِذَا رَأَوْا تِجَارَةً أَوْ لَهْوًا فَضُّوا إِلَيْهَا وَتَرَكُوكَ قَائِمًا قل ما عند الله خير من اللهو ومن التجارة والله خير الرازقين والله خير الرازقين.
Allah Azza wa Jal is the best of providers. My dear respected brothers in Islam, what is rizq? What is rizq? You see, in Lisan al-Arab, it's a dictionary, very famous one, probably the most famous with the Arabs. By Ibn Manzur, he mentions that rizq is هو ما تقوم به حياة كل كائن حي ماديا كان هذا أو معنويا. He says, rizq is anything that a living person needs, be it literal or metaphorical. Now what does this mean? Rizq could be two things, either literal or metaphorical. The literal thing, your money, your wealth, your possession, your land, your car. This is your rizq. The metaphorical. You see, rizq is not just around this little circle of money, wealth, and possession. It's far greater than that. Rizq, you'll find it with your children. Rizq is your time when you are free. Rizq is your health when you feel healthy and there's no need for you to go to the hospital. Rizq is with your spouse when you are living a beautiful life with your spouse. Rizq is in the metaphorical sense, not just the literal sense with the money and possession and the wealth. You see, rizq, my dear respected brothers in Islam, in the metaphorical side, for some people, they can't get children. For some people, they can't get children. And you have children. This is your rizq. This is what Allah Azza wa Jalla has given you. And that person who doesn't have children, maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has opened up the doors of the wealth and the bounty that He wants to give him from possessions and cars and wealth and property. Rizq is either literal or metaphorical. You think about it in your life. You think in your life, how much has Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given to you? Forget the literal sense. Think of the metaphorical. How much of Allah Azza wa Jal has given us in the days and the nights? And sometimes we think we've hit rock bottom. Sometimes we open our wallets and we think it's empty. And I need money. I need rizq. And yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you so much. He has given you so much. My dear respected brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentions in the Quran a very beautiful verse. وَلَئِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. Allah Azza wa Jal, He says that if you thank me, I will give you more. If you thank me for the things that I have given you, if you thank Allah Azza wa Jal for the two children that He has, and you want more children, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you. If you thank Allah Azza wa Jal for the business that you are running, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you barakah in your business, and it will grow. If you thank Allah Azza wa Jal for the possession that you own, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you. This is not words that are coming from some smart person. It's words from Allah Azza wa Jal. He says to you, وَلَئِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. That if you thank me, I will give you. I will give you extra. I will multiply it in abundant amounts. My brothers in Islam, how do we obtain rizq? How do we obtain rizq? Three ways. First way is the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fearing Allah Azza wa Jal, being God conscious. You see, when you are God conscious and you know that Allah Azza wa Jal is watching you and you know that there's going to be a haram transaction if you are going to go ahead with the business transaction that you are going to do, and you fear Allah Azza wa Jal and you say, I'm not going to do it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you in other ways. And He will amplify your wealth. And He will give you because you feed Him. You feed Allah Azza wa Jal. There's a very beautiful story, very famous one. A young man who was a student of knowledge. He was once walking and he got very, very hungry. And he was passing a farm and he saw a tree with some apples on it. Very, very hungry. Picks the apple, eats it. takes his first bite. The first bite, he thought to himself, Ya Allah, I have disobeyed you. I haven't even asked the owner of the land if I can even eat from this apple. So God conscious from the very first bite. He feed Allah Azza wa Jal. He didn't want to disobey Allah Azza wa Jal. He didn't want to steal from the person who owns the land. An apple. One bite of an apple. He started to ask around, who owns this farm? Who owns this land? I want to know. They said to him, go to this house. You'll find the owner there. He goes to the house, knocks on the door. A man opens to him. He explains his story. Now this person, the owner of the farm, was shocked. He couldn't believe himself. Why is this man coming to ask me for forgiveness for one bite of an apple? One bite of, what is that worth? $1? Right? Nothing. Worth nothing. Something very basic. And he's coming to me to ask me for forgiveness. So he was very, very astonished with this man's character. So he says to him, I'll forgive you only if you do one thing. He says to him, I'm ready. Whatever you want, I'll do it. I'll do it. So he says to him, you marry my daughter. Allahu Akbar. I marry your daughter? Allahu Akbar. I marry your daughter? Really? He says to him, yeah, but hang on, there's a catch. She's deaf, she's dumb, she's blind, and she's mute. You know that awkward silence with the crickets? What do I do? For an apple. One bite. I'm going to spend the rest of my life taking care of this woman. He thought about it. He was God conscious. He feared Allah Azza wa Jal. He said, I fear Allah Azza wa Jal. It comes priority over my desires. I'll take the woman. He agreed. The day of nikah came. The day of the wedding came. He enters upon a woman in which was his wife. So she stands up and she looks at him. He says, oh my God, I'm in the wrong room. She says to him, no, you're not. I'm your wife. He says, what do you mean? Your father told me that you're deaf, dumb, blind, and now you're speaking to me. So she says to him, yes, I'm deaf. I don't listen to the haram. I'm dumb. I don't speak the haram. I'm blind from looking at the haram and I'm disabled from walking to the haram. My dad has been looking for a man to marry me for such a long time. And now he found you with this beautiful character. So he chose you for me. And this person, you know who his offspring was? Al-Imam Abu Hanifa. Imam Abu Hanifa. These were his parents. Right? Such a beautiful story. Why? Because he feared Allah Azza wa Jal. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him rizq. He gave him a beautiful spouse in which his offspring came a very, very knowledgeable scholar. My brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions in the Quran, وَمَن يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبًا. Whoever fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will give him a way out. He will find for him a way out. And he will give him and sustain him in ways he didn't even think is possible. He will give him in ways that he didn't even think is possible. My brothers in Islam, another way to attain rizq is to have true tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. True tawakkul, reliance on Allah azza wa jal. When I say tawakkul, we say, yeah, you know what, I do rely on Allah azza wa jal. But sometimes our hearts, they become a bit rusty. And what do? We have true reliance on our boss and the paycheck that he's going to give us at the end of the week and the figures that enter our bank accounts, right? And the cash that we have in our hands. This is our true reliance. Sometimes we lean over to that side. You see, we need to have true reliance on Allah Azza wa Jal because he is the best of providers. He is the one who provides, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions in the Quran, وَمَا لَنَا أَلَّا نَتَوَكَّلَ عَلَى اللَّهِ. What is wrong with us? What is wrong with us? We don't have true reliance on Allah Azza wa Jalla, and he's the one who guided us onto the straight path. What's wrong with us? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentions in an authentic hadith, لو توكلتم على الله حق توكله لرزقكم كما يرزق الطير. That if you were to rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala true reliance, He will give you, He will provide for you as He provides for the bird. You see, the bird flaps its wing in the morning with an empty stomach, and he comes back at night with a full stomach. If you have true reliance on Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide for you as He provides for all of the animals. My dear respected brothers in Islam, the third way to attain rizq, to attain the rizq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the dua. It is to raise your hands and ask Allah Azza wa Jal, Ya Allah, give me. Ya Allah, I want something. Ya Allah, give me offspring. Ya Allah, give me wealth. Ya Allah, give me a car. Ya Allah, give me time. Ya Allah, give me health. Raise your hands and ask Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah wants to hear you. Allah wants to hear you asking Him. So ask Him and He will give you. You see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentions in the Quran the story of Zakariya, in which He says, هُنَالِكَ دَعَى زَكَرِيَّا رَبَّهُ قَالَ رَبِّ هَبْ لِي مِنْ لَدُنْكَ ذُرِّيَّةً طَيِّبَةً إِنَّكَ سَمِيعُ الدُّعَاءِ. It is there in which Zakariya alayhi salam raised his hands and he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, give me offspring. Ya Allah, give me pure offspring. You are the one who answers the call. What happens? Immediately, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He answers. فَنَادَتْهُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَهُوَ قَائِمٌ يُصَلِّي فِي الْمِحْرَابِ وَهُوَ قَائِمٌ يُصَلِّي فِي الْمِحْرَابِ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يُبَشِّرُكَ بِيَحْيَى. It is there, in the sanctuary, while Zakariya was praying, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the angels, and the angels call upon him, Ya Zakariya! Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you glad tidings with Yahya. He gives you glad tidings with Yahya, your son. Raise your hands and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us rizq in this world. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا أَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سار على دربه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد, my dear respected brothers in Islam, on a day-to-day occasion, we wake up in the morning, we leave our homes, we go to work seeking our rizq, our sustenance, and sometimes we hit brick walls, sometimes we hit right at the bottom, rock bottom. Sometimes we've got no more. But if you have true reliance on Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah will give you. In the right time. You see, sometimes you think, I need this now. But Allah Azza wa Jal has better plans for you, because He knows you, because He created you. So He will give it to you when you most need it. If you have true reliance on Allah Azza wa Jal, you have a debt that you need to pay off. Have true reliance on Allah, and the money will come. The money will come. Wallahi, I know stories of brothers. He told me he applied for 150 jobs in his field. Nothing. Nothing. No one accepted. He's getting married next week. He signed two contracts yesterday. Signed two contracts. Massive engineering company. His dream job. Allah Azza wa Jal will give you the rizq in the time that you need it. If you have a child coming on the way, and for the ones who do have children, you know, automatically Allah Azza wa Jal opens doors for you. Automatically Allah Azza wa Jal increases your rizq for the child that's coming. My dear respected brothers in Islam, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your daily transactions. Have tawakkul on Allah azza wa jal, true reliance on Him. And raise your hands and ask Him for the rizq, for verily He is the best of providers. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bestow His rizq upon all of us. Ya la 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 la
لا 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 لا